the Targa Florio, created in 1906 by the wealthy pioneer racing driver and automobile enthusiast Vincenzo Florio, who had started the Copper Florio race in 1900. Always one of the toughest competitions in Europe, the first Targa Florio covered 277 miles of treacherous Sicilian mountain roads at heights where severe changes in climate often occurred. Mid-1920s, the Targa Florio had become one of Europe's most important races, as neither the 24-hour of Le Mans nor the Mille Miglia had yet been established, and Grand Prix races were still isolated events, not a series like today's F1. In 1926, Eliska Junkova, one of the greatest female drivers in history, became the first woman to ever compete in the race. We'll be right back. 1955, the Targa became part of the new FIA World Sportscar Championship. Mercedes had to win 1-2 to beat Ferrari for the title, having missed the first two of the six events. Stirling Moss and Peter Collins beat Fangio and Kling to win the title. Over the years, many of the greats of Grand Prix racing, such as Fangio, Moss and Belgian Olivier Gendebien, took on Italian champions such as Tuzzo Nuvolari, Michele Varzi and local hero Nino Vaccarella. The racing cars were started one by one every 2 minutes for a time trial, as a start from a full grid was not possible on the tight and twisty roads. Due to the long track, drivers practiced in the week before the race in public traffic, often with their race cars fitted with license plates.
Roads of Targa Florio have been a teaching ground to all drivers. The most important manufacturers in the world have come here to test their cars. Porsche has given the name Targa to one of its models, proof that these roads are really demanding and offer the possibility for the most thorough and complete tests. I would also add that, as a race, Targa Florio exacted the utmost dedication from a driver. Targa Florio races were important in making Sicily better known far beyond the frontiers of Italy. For example, in the United States, Mafia, Targa Florio. These were the two things they remembered. This competition, the oldest in the world, together with Indianapolis, has made Sicily known the world over. Count Florio's road race had 295 corners each lap, with a gear change on every one of them. Competitors got back to the pits clocking anywhere near 40 minutes, they were doing very well indeed.
The Ferrari GTO is also in for a quick check on its fore and aft rebuilding. Scarpiotti is still in second place, but soon there's drama in the Ferrari pit when team manager Drugoni learns that the car's steering has gone and it's a bit bent in consequence. Vaccarella's going even faster. Lap 2 takes him less than the magic 40. 39.21 to be exact, 39.3 seconds inside the previous record. There's that GTO again after modifications. Vaccarella in action. Manioli. The circuit itself is a place for pedestrians as well as for cars, and sitting on the outside of a bend, legs dangling, means nothing to Luigi. It's a picnic fiesta, and a roaring racing car doesn't stop you trumping your partner's ace. Colasano for the last time. And onto the coast road. 10 kilometers to go, and 6 of them straight. So Vaccarella and Bandini win for Ferrari, with Porsche second, third, fourth, and fifth. What a triumph for the Sicilian-born driver, the headmaster from Palermo, who now joins the great names of the Targa winner.
In the late 1960s and early 1970s, hugely powerful cars such as Vaccarella's Ferrari 512 raced through small mountain villages, while the people were sitting or standing right next to or even on the road. Porsche, on the other hand, did not race its big Porsche 917, but rather the nimble Porsche 908 Spiders.
There were only a handful of great road courses still left for endurance racing. Le Mans was one, another was the Targa Florio around the public highways of Sicily.
There are in the region of 900 corners per single lap, and each lap is approximately 43 miles round, so you can imagine the problems of learning a circuit of this type. Normally, a difficult circuit to learn, say the Nürburgring, with 170 corners and about 14 miles round, you can learn in, say, 60 laps. But to do 60 laps round here, in a road car, would mean about 60 hours of driving, and to find that sort of time is pretty difficult.
I think in some ways it's more frightening going round in practice than in the race. This is an interesting piece which is blind. Normal day with normal traffic, so to watch the how much road we use, it's very narrow at the best of times, and in the race you have to be very careful at all times not to touch the curbs and to try and avoid the gutters because of nails which are left by the horse's shoes.
out through the right and left flick. Watch it here because the road surface changes. And again as fast as possible on the approach to the hairpin. Careful through here. Day, these walls will be just solid with people. They'll be standing on them, sitting on them, and all you can see is legs and feet, like driving through a tunnel almost. Targa Florio, aside from staying on the road, is to go as fast as possible for as long as possible. Fast through that one. Fast through this one. And brake all over the road for the hairpin, because you have to slow down for the hairpin anyway. Accelerate smoothly. Then tuck in round this corner, mind the little stones that cut the tyres. Fast through that one. Then apex for this one just around the corner because you want to be on the right coming down the hill. It's fast onto the bridge because the surface is quite good. Then accelerate again for this short straight.
Safety concerns, the last real Targa Florio was an international professional race run in 1973. The Targa was continued as a national event for some years before a fatal crash sealed its fate in 1977. Like the Mille Miglia, since then it's been run as a rallying event.